was a great pickup for them. We'll hear from Shane a little bit later on some of his thoughts on what went into that victory. Liam Rush gets a little closer, can't come up with the score. Graham Dan with the body and the screen out, pulls down the board.
Tim Lang's checked into the game for the Melbourne Tigers as well. He started against the Adelaide 36ers, only played limited minutes. That brings that size.
Grant with a pull-up. That's an air ball. Graham Dan throws it over the top. Benny Lewis picks it off. He loses the handle, but he eventually gets the layup. That was not pretty, but he gets the score, and we're all tied up at 14.
I tell you what. Scoring points tonight. It's been like pulling teeth.
Luke Martin tries to get it to Grant. Like, both teams a little reluctant to take one as Liam Rush cuts down the middle. And the Melbourne Tigers score the first 4 points of the second quarter. That's no call. Oh, my goodness. A lot of contact. Lang goes upstairs and gets the score. And Shane Heal doesn't like what he sees and calls a timeout. Melbourne Tigers score the first 6 points of the second quarter and take an 18-14 lead near the Kingdom.
Limited time only. Out of this world finance offer. No deposit. 50 months interest free at Super A-Mart. Buy furniture, bedding and outdoor with no interest to pay till May 2016. Super A-Mart. Smart. Nobody beats Super A-Mart.
Why pay cash to sell your car? Why have people constantly calling you on the phone?
Ben's car, Chloe's car, Finn's car, your mom's car, Dave's car, Amy's car, your car, Eric's car.
Welcome back to the King Dome. Shane Heal doing the coaching. Spoke with him before the game, and I asked him about, well, last week the Kings get a win, and they've got one win under their belt with him as the head coach, and now they're talking about around the city that this is a game he should win against the Melbourne Tigers. This is what he had to say.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it? But I mean, you certainly don't underestimate any team when you're 8-14 or 9-14 or whatever the team is. We'd lost 5 in a row, so for us to be able to come out hungry to be able to play D again, hopefully we can play the defense because we should get some easy baskets out of that. But you know, it's going to come down to a mindset and a commitment, and hopefully the guys are hungry.
Sydney Kings, during that chat, just burped it up again for their third straight turnover. They haven't even gotten a shot off here in the second quarter is Benny Lewis, who gets a steal and a score and then knocks down a jumper.
9 straight points. Oh, excuse me, only a 2 on that. 8 straight points for the Melbourne Tigers. And correct me if I'm wrong, Steve, that's 4 straight turnovers in the backcourt for the Sydney Kings. They can't get it over the halfway line.
No. You're exaggerating because Luke Martin turned the ball over in the paint. So 3 of the 4 turnovers have been in the backcourt.
Mike.
But you're not exaggerating
goodness.
By a whole lot.
Unbelievable. And straight away, Ben Manchin comes back to try and help stem the tide of turnovers. My goodness, Steve, unprecedented. With the way the Sydney Kings have just had a run of turnovers. I know the Melbourne Tigers have extended their D and put a little bit of pressure, but my goodness, they've got to be better than that.
You must. It is, as a ball carrier, a little embarrassed that your team, Luke Cooper looked like he traveled.
Oh, no.
And eventually Sydney get it up, get it to Kazoo for the jam. Textbook on how you break pressure, but eventually they break the 9-0 scoring run of the Melbourne Tigers. Lang over to Liam Rush. Traga against Grant, gets it to Lewis. He's wide open. Rush on the offensive glass. Now it's the Melbourne Tigers who are outworking the Sydney Kings on the boards. Cooper gets it up to Bowes. His jump hook is good. And I know he knocked that shot down, but he misses that one. That's exactly playing into the hands of the Melbourne Tigers in that extended pressure.
Well, it
even
is.
Though they didn't turn it over.
You're right, but the last two times we've seen the Sydney Kings break that pressure and come down and make some baskets, and that's one way to get them thinking about applying that full court extended D, is to come in and just break the front line of that full court extended press and come out with easy layups.
And that's how you have to break it down. At the end of the day, if Tim Lang is coming over to pressure you, he is a center. Make him slide his feet and play some defense. And don't panic and try and throw it over the outstretched arm of a 6'11" guy.
Well, that's right.
Make him slide his feet. Bowes turns down to three.
Anatoly Bowes, Steve. He is, without a doubt, the Rookie of the Year. I'm willing to call it right now before we even get to the end of the season. You're looking at the Rookie of the Year in Anatoly Bowes, and he's really upped his scoring for the Kings as the season has gone on. In the first 10 games this season, he averaged 12.5 points, but only shot it at 37% from the field and was held to single-figure scoring five times. But since then, Steve, in the last 10 games, he's averaged 17 points and shot it at 42%. From the field and is scored in double figures every single game. So yeah. He has turned his season around.
He looks very comfortable, and I mean, you've raved about him for quite some time, but his numbers have consistently gotten better. You can just tell he has a better feel for how the game is being played as you check out the steals. And due to this quarter, Melbourne Tigers up 5-0. Something that Shane Heal wants to see when he wants his team to focus on the defensive end. Dillon puts it on the floor, gets it back to Lewis, shot clock down to five, Cam Tregod comes up short. Sydney get the stop. Skip it ahead to Bowes. Some footwork, can't get the layup to kiss off the backboard, and it'll go back to the Sydney Kings.
Steve, I like Anatoly Bowes. We've seen a little more in this game in the open court as well. When he's given that license just to attack the rim. We've seen the last couple of times he's very good at finding his way to the basket and creating scoring opportunities just in that freelance transition type environment.
Ben Magin's pulling up, going right.
On the rebound, the foul was called. One thing we can see in the Shane Heal era is that Kevin Rash is not playing. He's yet to enter the game tonight. He's available, but just through coach's decision, I believe.
It might be a coincidence, but it might be the fact that he feels like he can only concentrate on so many guys.
That's correct. And, you know, with him coming in, it would take minutes away from a guy like Anatoly Bowes or Jarae Grant. And he's just limiting the rotation now. And really, only going with eight players. That's all he's gone with so far tonight.
Bowes with the pump fake. Well, he's getting a little better at selecting when he waits for the player to come down.
Rather than jumping into someone.
There you go.
He's just getting the guy off balance. And here we see it. A little shot fake. And just there waits for Liam Rush to fall into him.
Looking a little more fluent at the foul line. Also, remember the game that we did. He just struggled from the line as Sydney Kings capitulated in the second half. Just as I gave him some credit there, he kind of shorthands that one. Lewis on the end of another good pass from Daniel Dillon.
And given the struggles that both these teams are having in the half court, that's really been both teams' most reliable offense has been that transition basket.
Bowes from deep comes up short. Dillon going to that right hand, gets it to Lewis. That's short. Lucas Walker goes upstairs. Nobody screened him out. Bowes with numbers to Grant. Two shots as he rode
two shots. Well, that's
that
interesting.
Was interesting, yeah.
Because we have a look at the replay here. There you see the foul. He got the benefit of the doubt on that occasion.
He did. I thought it was a good foul because he fouled him before he got into a shooting motion.
I'm not sure Jerome Grant was expected to go to the line either. But he ends up there. And it's free throw shooting hasn't been a real solid area for either of these teams throughout the course of the season. And tonight, not great for the Sydney Kings. 7 of 13. 8 of 14 now, 57%. Little zone defense by the Sydney Kings.
Lewis gives it over to Dylan Walker. He gets to the rim. Boy, he is. Well, he's determined to get to the rim. He can get there.
And he's long, and he's got such athleticism. He can go up in the air, and he's got that extended hang time that allows him to make baskets like that. The little shot that he's got to have nice touch. It's nice to have those sort of ups.
Jerome Grant, his medium-range jump shot is off the mark. Boy, if he could get more consistent with that, he would be a monster to guard. Long and athletic. As long and as athletic as they get in this league, Rush misses the sitter. Kazoo with the handle, gets it to Magin. He finds Grant. He gets the soft finish. And Sydney inching back into this one. Now the lead has been cut down to 5. Shane Heal has tried to bring to the Sydney Kings, I guess you could say, is the success is the Kings with those scoring droughts trying to stay close and weather the storm during those periods where they're sluggish on the offensive end and able to hopefully pick it up on the offensive end and get the points with the same defensive effort to slow their opponent down.
Well, that's right, Stephen. We spoke to Shane before the start of the game. And you know, before he first game against Townsville, he could only put in 2 plays. He only had 2 plays that he could go to of a structured variety coming in. Now, he's had this week to prepare, but tonight, you see that they've been real erratic on the offensive end. And I think that at this time of the game, Shane Hill calls the timeout. You know, you look at it with 4 minutes to go in the second quarter and you've held the Tigers to 29 points, you go, well, okay, there's room to improve, but that's not too bad. But to only have 24 points, he'd be working and talking about how to get a little bit more efficiency and productivity on the offensive end. They're only shooting at 33%, but they've been pushed out a lot of their stuff in the half-court stuff. The Melbourne Tigers have done a good job to get in the lanes and force them into some broken plays, and I'm sure the hammer in that timeout was focusing on the offensive end.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more, and like you said, I like what you touched on there. Give Trevor Gleason and the Melbourne Tigers some credit because they've done a good job of forcing the Sydney Kings, for one, with their extended pressure and the turnovers, and two, once they get in their half-court sets, way out in the wings, way out in the high post, that Julian Kazoo way out of the three-point line. So Tigers have been muscling the Kings around. Rush to Allen. Burston, shot clock down to 5. Extra pass goes to Tommy Greer. That comes up short.
That was great ball movement by the Melbourne Tigers. Got it through a lot of sets of hands and fired as a wide open shot just knocked by Tommy Greer. Just not able to knock it down. And there's almost a sacrificial foul by Graham Dan just to stop the transition basket. But you saw that play there, Steve. The Tigers, as I mentioned, got it through sets of hands. I was reading some statistics of the game, particularly the second half against the Adelaide 36ers. And in that second half, they only had an average of 2.5 passes per possession in the second half. And what that suggests is they're very terminal in the half court.
Where did you get that stat from?
It was through the great work that's done on the internet. on the NBL.com. Check it out for all the goings-on in the NBL as Benny Lewis flashes the trifecta.
You know, whoever came up with that stat really needs a girlfriend. That is really something to dissect the game like that.
Well, they had 35 possessions in the second half and only had 27 points.
Bowes with the three-point bomb. That's long. Sidney Kings is coming up with some blanks. 8 of 26 from the field as Tommy Greer's shot is short. I like it better when he shoots a jump shot.
You're dead right. He's almost better on the move or coming off a dribble. Ben Maggin a little bit of, don't argue, giving you a little push in the back. Just showing the passion of these two teams. Ben Maggin's another one. I went to shake his hand before during shoot-around. Here we see it coming in here. Goes with the left. Just a little whack there. Oh, and we don't see it. There was just a little push in the back by Ben Maggin. But he goes to the line to shoot too. But I went to shake his hand and he had to change hands. Got a problem with his, I believe it's his fifth metacarpal.
All right, he wasn't doing the Brett Maher. You know Brett Maher would never let you touch his shooting hand when he was playing.
Maybe that's it. Well, I said, you got a problem with your hand, and I mentioned the fifth metacarpal. He said, yeah, but you might have actually gone on to something there, Steve. Because the way he's behaving tonight, doesn't seem like there's too many problems with the hands. My goodness.
Yeah, he doesn't mind the ball touching it, that's for sure, as the Lion takes one on the head. Sidney Kings, often when you're troubled with extended pressure, what helps is putting a little extended pressure on your opponent.
Yes.
Dorsey moving to his right, kind of shot himself, kind of dribbled himself out of rhythm on that. Stan will help Luke Martin bring the ball up.
Ron Dorsey, 1 of 5 tonight. Only got the 2 points to his name. It's the unlikely Benny Lewis who leads the way for the Melbourne Tigers with 9 points and seeing extended minutes as a reward. Look out! Look out!
Dorsey misses the jam. Trevor Gleason telling him to hurry up and get back as Kazoo gets the score. So it's a 4-point swing for the Sidney Kings as Ron Dorsey trying to take off a little too far with a little showtime.
He did. He just tried to, needed one more dribble, one more step, and he would have had his elbows up near the rim, but offensive foul now on the block on the screen. So things starting to go the way of the Sydney Kings.
Well, Sydney bring it up. Down 4. 28 points and just down 4 as Julian Kazoo backs it in. His fall away is off the mark. Dorsey with the board gets it to Lewis. Bursting. Dorsey eventually gobbles it up. Shot clock down to 6. Pull up. Good by Benny Lewis. Benny Lewis is feeling it. He's in double figures on 5 of 7 shooting.
And Steve, this is one that would be catching Shane Hill and the Sydney Kings off guard a little bit because Benny Lewis's minutes this year have been very erratic. And he's making the most of his time right now. 5 of 7 from the field. He's got 11 points, but maybe it's a sign of why he may have troubles in seeing more minutes. That's the only stat he has outside of a steal. So he hasn't had an assist and he hasn't had a rebound as yet.
Martin Itty into the game for Julian Kazoo, making sure the big sneeze doesn't pick up a cheap one before halftime. And Kazoo just with 1 foul. Well, just 29 seconds to go. We want him to pick up number 2. Martin misses him both. Graham Dan.
Now that is inexcusable. on behalf of the Melbourne Tigers to get an offensive rebound on a free throw. Just forget about you. They're just a brain freeze as far as your fundamentals are concerned, blocking out.
Imagine going left, looking for a teammate. Martin's got to get one off just before the shot clock expires. And Bose picks up a foul with 0.73 of a second.
Not great foul, Steve, but they're not in the bonus yet, so it's not as expensive as it possibly could have been.
3 seconds from the corner when he took the rebound on the ball, just coming to the front. Probably got to have at least one and a half, if not two on it.
Yeah, I think I've
got a little bit. Two. Four. Four. We get you back to 2 seconds, please. Got the rebound at three. It's a short little pick. 1 second.
Timeout. I think he's being a little generous with that one.
I thought he was too. Timeout. Trevor Gleeson is going to try and draw up a play. And obviously you don't have a lot of time. Ball's got to be taken out of bounds in the backcourt. So Trevor may actually go to his bench here and maybe bring on his mosquito fleet, anyone that can shoot it from the perimeter. And it's really only going to be a catch and one, possibly two dribbles before you need to shoot it. So it's all about getting someone free, hopefully going towards the basket. If you've got to run to the backcourt, get it, turn around, and then attack the rim, that's going to take a lot of time. So he's going to have to go to his bag of tricks. You can't advance the ball in this circumstance, so you've got to go where the ball was... the foul was committed, and that was about a three-quarter court.
Yeah, one player they might be looking for is Benny Lewis. As I mentioned, 11 points on 5 of 7 shooting. And, you know, sometimes when a team is struggling with their form, a young player will emerge with an opportunity, and we have been hoping that one of those young players would be Benny Lewis for quite some time. It looks like Lucas Walker as well.
Hey, Benny Lewis has got the skill. You can see with what his game is, the way he's played tonight, he's got the talent. Comes from great pedigree with his dad, one of the legends of the NBL, playing in the 80s.
Yeah, his dad was just a scoring machine, and it looks as if Benny Lewis is, boy, not only has he got his genes, he's got a good version of his genes. He's longer and just as athletic.
The fumble. The fumble by Cam Tregarth-Custom. You can't script that up at halftime.